Dear comrades, dear friends, us, the Friends of Peace, we are gathered here in Caracas to declare once again our determination to the anti-imperial struggle, our determination to the fight for the democratic right of the peoples to live peacefully and freely, to have a life without the constant fear of war, to have a life without death and destruction. From the homeland of Bolivar, we join our voices with the resisting people of Venezuela, and we send a loud and clear message to the world. We want everyone to know that the planned coup against the legitimate president of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, Nicolás Maduro, is not an action that will be tolerated. This attempt of intervention, guided by the U.S. with the EU and the majority of the members of the Organization of American States, it must be clear to everyone that it is only another part of the plans of imperialists to control the country's natural wealth, such as oil and other valuable resources. While Venezuela is suffering by all the kinds of attacks, economic, media, physical sabotages, the President of the United States declaring since the last summer that even the possibility of a military intervention is not excluded. We are here to stand by the side of the Venezuelan people, to denounce those destabilizing strategies and the imposition of embargoes and sanctions towards Venezuela. Neither U.S. nor the EU or any other has the right to interfere in the internal affairs of any country. Not to Venezuela, not anywhere. The sovereign people of Venezuela, like every people, have a responsibility for deciding on their own government without interference. The cries of imperialism about human rights and democracy can be characterized at least as hypocrisy. The same forces who aim this destabilization and who are hoping to activate international law regulations, such as the so-called responsibility of protection, in order to invade, are the same who are supporting regimes such as Saudi Arabia, who threatens a whole generation in Yemen with extinction. They are the same forces who, during the last decades, have killed millions of people in Syria, Iraq, Afghanistan, the same who invaded Vietnam, who orchestrated the Turkish invasion in Cyprus, who bombed Yugoslavia, and the list never ends. We know that the imperialistic operation against Venezuela is dated. With the election of Hugo Chavez in 1998, the United States set the goal of overthrowing its government with the first failed attempt at 2002 military coup. It is no coincidence that the United States has permanently encircled all of Latin America and the Caribbean with 74 military bases, with 13 of them encircling Venezuela. In addition, they use their weapons of mass destruction against the process of sovereignty and self-determination of the peoples of the region. In the recent past, the United States, with the help of their local allies, carried a series of interventions in Latin America as they overthrew elected leaders of Honduras, Paraguay, Brazil, Bolivia, and Ecuador, while at the same time they are hoping to make Cuba kneel to them with their economic war. Now, in an attempt to present to the international community their own will as the will of the people of Venezuela, they came up with another plan that includes the puppet called Juan Guaido, a representative of the extreme right and the oligarchy of Venezuela. The recognition of Guaido as the president of the country after his self-declaration is an action fully in line with the most aggressive US, EU, and NATO policy to promote their interests in the Latin America region. Friends and comrades, clearly the United States is attempting an economic coup in order to strangle the country through hyperfiltration and political turbulence in order to end the Bolivarian project and everything that it gave to the people. In this destabilizing strategy, the local oligarchy and the right-wing opposition are fully coordinated. As in any cases of interventions, the same way in Venezuela, imperialism has its local allies, the traitors of the country, the traitors of the people of Venezuela. Dear comrades, as the World Federation of Democratic Youth, we carry a duty towards the people of this country. We can give a promise to the struggling people of this country that we will not compromise and that we will not stay quiet. We will make sure that the voice of the truth the voice of peace, friendship and solidarity will be heard loud in every corner of the world. This is how we can make it difficult for those who are planning to intervene to find any support. On the other side now, there is another major task for the people of the country. To defend your country, to defend your right, to demand what is yours to stay yours, and not to allow to any puppet to break the unity of the Venezuelan people. Once again, we express our solidarity and we declare our total support to the just struggle of the Venezuelan people. In this fight, we stand together. Determination to the principles of the anti-imperial struggle, unity, militance, faith to the people, and we have nothing to be afraid of. Imperialist, hands off Venezuela. Long live the anti-imperialist of the world. Long live international solidarity. Long live the struggling people of Venezuela.